This is a lecture on source transformation, and source transformation is based on the concept of equivalent circuits, which we're going to get to next lecture. But what you can do with source transformation is shown in this diagram, where either for independent sources or dependent sources, you can transform between voltage and current sources. So for example, you can go from a voltage source in series with the resistance to a current source in parallel with the resistance, or you can go the other way. You can go from a current source in parallel with the resistance to a voltage source in series with the resistance. And this is true for independent sources and also dependent sources, which is shown down here in the diagram. Now, when you go from a voltage source to a current source, this is how you get the current source value, just with Ohm's law, with the voltage source divided by the resistance. And when you go from current source to voltage source, this is how you get the voltage source value, and it's just, again, with Ohm's law, the current source value times the resistance. So I think the best way to learn about source transformation is by doing a couple of problems. So let me bring this up here. Okay, here's a problem where we have a current source and a voltage source, as you can see, several resistors, and we're asked for the current through this 5 ohm resistor. So what we're going to do is we're going to solve this using source transformation. I'm going to transform one of these sources so that I end up with two of the same type of sources. And usually, at least in some cases, that's an advantage, that if you have two of the same type of sources, it'll make the problem easier, because a lot of times you can combine those two same sources into an equivalent single source. Now, at the start here, it may appear we have our choice, either to transform this current source and this 5 ohm resistor, okay, this parallel current source and resistor, into a series voltage source and series resistance, or, you know, if we combine these two resistors in series here, the 7 and 4, right, in series, that's an 11 ohm resistor, of course. Well, I could take this and transform it into a parallel current source and resistance. So it looks at first we have our choice. We can either go current source to voltage source here, or go voltage source to current source here. But you see, we have to do this transformation. Our only choice, even though it appears we have two, we only have one choice, that we have to go from voltage source to current source, because see, we want the current through this 5 ohm resistor that's in parallel with this current source. So if we were to transform the current source along with this resistor, we would essentially lose that current, okay? So that's one thing you always have to look out for, that if you're trying to solve for something that involves the current source and the resistor, or if you're trying to solve for something for either the source or the resistor that you wish to transform, you can't do it, okay? Because again, what's going to happen is you're going to lose essentially that quantity that you're trying to solve for. So what we're going to do here is I'm going to redraw the circuit. Okay, so we still got the 3 amp in parallel with the 5 ohm here. And now I'm going to transform this 9 volt along with the 11 ohm resistor. So when I transform that, okay, so this is still 3 amps. We didn't do anything to the 3 amp and the 5 ohm. Okay, and we're still after this current through the 5 ohm. Okay, this is going to be 11 ohms. Okay, but now when I show this voltage source now as a current source, the value is going to be the voltage source value of 9 divided by the resistance 11. So you see now this is 9/11 amps. And then when I put in the arrow for the current source, the tip of the arrow always goes with the plus of the voltage source. So you see the arrow's going up. Okay, so this is after I transform this voltage source and this series resistance. This is the circuit I now have. So you can see it's a parallel circuit with two current sources. And when we have current sources in parallel, where the arrows are going the same direction, we can combine those current sources into a single current source where we add up their currents. See, just think KCL. When you do a KCL at this top node, both of those currents for the current sources would be flowing in, so they just add mathematically. So I'm just showing that as a source. I'm just showing that current that I would just have flowing in to that top node. I'm just showing it as a current source, see? So anytime you have current sources in parallel, if the arrows are going the same way, you can add them up. Now, if you have two current sources in parallel and the arrows are going different directions, well, then you take the difference and the arrow is going to point in the direction of the biggest current. So, you know, for example, if this 9 over 11 amps had an arrow going down, well, then we'd still have the arrow going up, but the value would be 3 minus 9/11, so it'd be 2 2/11. Okay? But you see, now what we're left with after we put in our equivalent current source is we're left with a parallel circuit, right? Current source, one current source, and two parallel resistors, 5 and 11. And I can use current divider to find what that current is. So you see, using current divider, it's just going to be 3, 9 over 11, times, let's see, this is the current through the 5 ohm. So using the form of current divider where there's a sum in the denominator, and I put the other resistor value in the numerator, so I want the current through the 5, so I put the 11 in the numerator, and then this would be 16. Okay, and let's see, I worked this out where this is 42 over 11, 11 over 16, 11's cancel out, so you get 42 over 16 amps, okay, which is 2.63 amps. Okay, so, you know, remember, we could solve this circuit without doing source transformation. So don't think that you have to use source transformation. It's just sometimes source transformation can make a problem easier to do. Okay, let's look at another example. Okay, here's an example where we want to know the voltage across this resistor here, this resistor that's in series with this voltage source. And then we've got two resistors in parallel with this current source. Well, again, it may appear at first that we can either do a source transformation on the voltage source and resistor, or source transformation on the current in parallel with these resistors. It may appear that we have a choice. But because we're after the voltage across this resistor that's in series with the voltage source, we can't do a transformation here. Okay, we can over here. It's okay over here because we don't want to find either a voltage or a current, you know, for any of these elements. So I'm going to leave the voltage source and this resistor, okay, the same. Okay, so this is still the 10. This is 25 volts. Okay, but now I'm going to combine these two resistors in parallel. So if you combine 30 in parallel at 20, okay, using product over sum, that's going to be 600 divided by 50. So that's 12 ohms. Okay, so I have an equivalent resistance of 12 ohms in parallel with this 5 amp source, so I can show that as a 12 ohm resistor in series with a voltage source. Okay, and to get the value of the voltage source, I take the current times the resistance value. So this would be 60 volts, 5 times 12. And now when I put the polarity of the voltage source, I put the plus at the tip of the arrow end. So you see the higher voltage end of that 60 volt source is on the bottom where the tip of the arrow of the current source was. Okay, so now as you can see, I have a series circuit with two voltage sources. And when you have two voltage sources where the polarity goes minus the plus, minus the plus, you can add those voltage sources to get a single equivalent voltage source. So I can combine the 25 and the 60 volt into an 85 volt source. And that 85 volt source is going to be in series with those two series resistors. Okay, this is 10. This is 12. See, if that plus for the voltage source, the 60 volt source, had been on top, you know, let's say that this arrow is pointing up, so we would put the plus on the top. Then when we combine these two voltage sources, since I go plus to minus, then minus the plus, I would take the difference. Okay, I would take the difference, and the polarity would be of the larger of the two. So in that case, you know, I'd have the difference 35 with the same polarity here as I show with the 85. But because as I go around this path right here where the voltage sources are, I'm going minus the plus, and then minus the plus, so that's additive. Just think KVL. When you do a KVL equation, it would be the same thing, that these two voltage sources would be, their values would be on the same side of the equal sign. Okay, so now, see, once I have this circuit here, I can just use voltage divider to find the voltage across that 10 ohm. So the voltage for the 10 ohm, which is V, would just be 85 times 10 over 22. And I'd have to put a minus because, as we talked about before, right, current's going like this, so the polarity, the higher end of the voltage across this 10 ohm resistor is actually right here on the left side. So it was defined like this, but that's the wrong polarity based on this current direction. So we indicate that with a minus sign. There'd be a minus sign right here in front. So the voltage across the 10 ohm, it's going to be minus 85 times 10 over 22, so 850 divided by 22 comes out to 38.64 volts. That's a dot. Okay, so just a couple of problems utilizing source transformation. Like I said at the beginning of the video, this is all based on, you know, the fact that you can transform sources like this is all based on a concept of equivalent circuits that we're going to start next lecture and spend quite a bit of time on. And then I just want to end with, again, emphasizing that source transformation is just something that, you know, is kind of in your bag of tricks, you know, your tool pouch, so to speak, of analyzing circuits. It's not something that has to be done. Again, we couldn't have solved each of these two circuits without doing source transformation, right? Because prior to this video, you know, we were solving circuits without source transformation. But it's just in some cases, source transformation can be helpful. As far as in this course, don't attempt source transformation unless you're told specifically to in a problem. You know, whether it's a homework problem or whether, you know, it's a exam problem, only use source transformation if you're told specifically to do so. Because what I have found in my experience is that students tend to go crazy with source transformation. You know, once they learn it, every time, you know, every circuit, they just see, you know, if they see a voltage source in series with the resistor, they automatically they'll convert it into a current source in parallel with the resistor, and vice versa. So they just go crazy with source transformation. Again, it's just something that sometimes helps, but it's not something you have to do all the time. So keep that in mind. So next video will be starting equivalent circuits, one of my favorite topics.